we're still going to be on Facebook. It doesn't matter. So what I want to see is if we pop up over on YouTube now.
Okay.
See if they let us in. See if they let us in the door.
You're live. You're live.
Let's see what happens now. Huh. Are we coming up?
There we are.
Holy crap. We're on YouTube.
Hello,
ladies
YouTube.
And gentlemen. YouTube. Thank you for letting us on.
So we just have to start later?
I guess. Whoa, look at this. We're on YouTube. I see myself. Yes! Subscribe to us on YouTube. Woo! Boom. So we got them working on both now, which is fantastic.
So now YouTube no longer chaps our ass.
I guess YouTube was like, all right, we'll let them on.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You know what I should have gone with was whatever you went with last week, because last week I did, what chap my ass was the thing you had the week before.
Yep.
You guys called me out on that.
Yeah, yeah. I'm sorry.
You know what else chaps my ass?
What?
Where's Jamie Nash?
Jamie Nash?
I don't see Jamie. He's like the fifth Beatle.
You know, he did comment on some of my stuff earlier today, and I was back and forth with him messaging right before the show, as a matter of fact.
Okay.
And then, boom, he's not there. I see Matt Sharp joined. I see Amy Young joined. Hey, guys, thanks for joining us. We are here on Facebook and over on YouTube, so you can comment on either one, and those comments are going to pop up. Yes, support filmmakers. Support indie filmmakers. Yes, thank you, D-Wayne. And by the way, D-Wayne, the Saints are going to lose. No, I don't know, man. They're tough, right? I think what we need to do, Dan, is when we get into it, get closer to the season, we do our predictions for each division.
Okay.
We pick each division. We don't go into it too much.
Or do we just do our division?
We just did our division. But I think we should do each division and make it quick, you know, because Robert, he'll get a little, you know.
He likes to talk football.
Yeah, he loves to talk football. As a matter of fact,
we can't get him to shut up when he starts talking football.
Yeah, we can't. It's terrible. We actually have a Broadway segment from Robert tonight. Yes, we do.
All right.
For all you Broadway fans out there, thanks for joining us. You're going to have a special treat tonight from Robert Neil Marshall, Jackson, Mississippi, Jr.
The third.
That's right. So, did you happen to see that I went to a swimming hole this week?
I did. I hear those places, they're dangerous, man. You can really hurt yourself there.
Oh, no, man. They're fun.
No.
Swing holes are fantastic. You know those zip line thingies?
Yes, I do.
I love them.
I'm very familiar with zip line thingies.
Right? And you know, it's a lot of fun. I got footage of me doing the zip line.
Okay.
Like Grace, and it's amazing. So I'm going to show it to you, and you can check this out. Ready? Here we go. There I am. Going. Here it is. Here comes the dismount, and boom!
Oh!
Yes! Yes! That was amazing, ladies and gentlemen.
Do we have a slower, closer version of that?
You know, I don't know. Look at that. That,
oh.
Oh, that's amazing, man. That was amazing, ladies and gentlemen.
The entry was a little splashy. I think the German judge did deduct points. But the level of difficulty, the degree of difficulty was... it was legit.
I hear you, but
you took a little sideways.
I meant to do that. I meant to go sideways, and you know, the dad gut body was flopping.
Well, that's also what happens when Jeff Wilhelm's not there to make it happen.
Exactly. See, he would have had a cable or something to spin me around even faster. All right, so check this out, ladies and gentlemen. You ready? Here it comes. The slower version of said flip. Ready? Boom. Here we go.
Here's the dismount.
Shoom.
Right here.
Here
it
comes.
There's good extension, and then you're pulling back up through
Ready?
The fulcrum.
Watch my foot. The toe goes out. There it goes. And
destination screwed.
Boom. Ladies and gentlemen. Woo.
I mean, that's the kind where just the second you hit, you go underwater, and you're like, I think I'm dead. I think I died.
Yeah, did you hear the noise at the end? That was my wife laughing her ass off. So my wife thought that was hilarious, that I almost murdered myself.
Almost the exact same thing happened to me on a zip line down in Virginia this summer. Luckily, the difference was that my wife wasn't rolling film. So, phone film.
Look at that! Victor Coco's on!
There we go.
Sweet! I wonder if these comments are popping up. You seeing any of them yet? Any of the YouTube comments in the feed?
I'm not seeing
any of them yet, but that doesn't mean that they won't pop up. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because they are supposed to, and they should. Yes, D-Wayne, La La Land still sucks. It's been out for, what, almost 2 years now?
Oh, just wait. We're getting to the Oscars in a minute.
Yeah, we're getting there. All right. So, Let's move on, man. Let's talk a little bit about sports. What do you think, you know? What do you think about that?
If we have to.
If we have to. The sports, Robert. Sorry, buddy. We're going to the sports. We're going to the football.
We are going to the football. Let me tell you about this football season so far.
Okay.
Because it only started like 92 hours ago, 96 hours ago.
Uh-huh.
You know, Thursday night, football season kind of opened. All the teams had their preseason games. And the Redskins season ended on Thursday night, and the Terps season ended on Friday.
Whew.
It was nuts
Are
around
here,
man.
Are you sure, though, the Redskins ended on Thursday night?
I mean, they're going to play 16 games, but I don't know that, you know, they had the fifth worst rushing attack last year.
You know, I really thought that guy was going to be good for you guys, too. Mm-hmm. I actually wanted us to draft him, but we made that trade with the Ravens.
Yeah.
And I wanted to take him in that slot, but
yeah.
We didn't. You know, you guys got him. I was a little jealous. But you know what? I still think he's going to be decent. You just got to wait a year.
Yeah, we're going to have to wait. So we've got that. And now we'll have a very high pick next year as well to put more people around him.
Yeah. Did you see the Giants? Barkley, he had a 39-yard run.
Yeah.
And then everybody in New York anointed him the next best rusher of all time. And he's already in the Hall of Fame.
Is he?
On a 39-yard preseason run.
Yeah.
After which... the Cleveland Browns defense shut them down.
Yeah.
They figured him out. Eli shut down. Barkley shut down. He didn't gain another 5 yards, I think.
Yeah.
And it was just like, okay, yeah, you're not going to the Hall of Fame. As a matter of fact, you're probably going to go 7-9 this first season. That's what I see. And it's not because of your running back. Your running back's going to be good. It's because of your quarterback, Giants fans. Sorry, Johnny G. But that's the problem.
You're going to get Sam mad at you.
I know. Sam Borowski's going to be mad.
Light you up. But no, I've been watching. So did you watch the first episode of Hard Knocks?
I did not. I don't watch Hard Knocks.
You don't?
No, I don't.
Okay.
I don't want to see that.
Okay.
Because it is Hard Knocks, and I feel bad for some of those guys.
Yeah, you
I've
do.
Been there. I know.
You do. Oh, yeah, you've been down that
I
road.
I know what it's like.
But
I,
it really
I've
is cool to see, like, the, especially the stuff they work on during the week, and then the game on, you know, the preseason game, and what's going into it, and who's got the position battles, and so it, you know, I watched some of that Browns game, figuring tomorrow night when Hard Knocks comes on, some of that will be in there, and mm-hmm. So it's pretty cool. But so yeah, Maryland. Right after I lose the new shiny Ferrari out of the Redskins season, the next day Maryland comes out and this horrible report comes out about the culture around that team.
What was that?
That was
insane. I read the article. I was like, oh my God, I can't believe that's going on at a Division I college program today. That's something like from the 70s.
It is.
You know?
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
But when we grew up with that, are you injured or are you hurt?
Yeah.
You know, get up.
Well, it's different today. You know? Mm-hmm. You can't coach kids like
well,
you coached
them. Well, it's supposed to be different, but clearly it's not.
You've got to develop. You've got to get out of that. And you've got to go. It's not about the screaming and the yelling. That doesn't work, man.
Yeah.
Doesn't work. Not with this generation.
Yeah.
You know, this generation, you've got to encourage, you've got to get out there, boom. It
shouldn't work.
Yeah.
Treat people...
with respect.
With respect.
You got it. Yep. You're absolutely right.
And then they'll kill themselves for you. You
mm-hmm.
won't have to push them to do it.
Yep. Well, it's a shame that that's happening.
Oh, shit. I didn't mean... because the kid died. That's...
I get it. I get it. No, it was a shame that kid died. You know?
And he died in May. Why did it take this long for this whole thing to come out?
I know. People were afraid.
Yep.
People were afraid for their jobs. People were afraid to lose their spot on the team.
Yep.
Whatever. That's the problem. That's what perpetuates all this. The same thing happened at Penn State. People were afraid.
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's why it didn't come out the way it should have when it happened. You know, it should have been nipped in the bud years ago, and it wasn't. Fortunately, well, not fortunately, because the kid lost his life, but at least it's not going to go on for years.
Yeah.
It's boom. Okay, that's it. We have to get this cleaned up, and we got to do it now.
Right.
We got to do a better job. That's it.
Hey, so. Roxanne.
Hey, Roxanne. Yep, I know Dan is gorgeous, and I just have a cool T-shirt on. There we have it. So, but that's football. The Eagles, they might not have Alshon Jeffrey for the first 5-6 weeks.
Okay.
They may not have Carson Wentz for the first 5-6 weeks.
Oh, you think that long?
That could hurt them.
See that picture of Carson Wentz in camp? He looks like a member of that Operation Mayhem or whatever it is from Fight Club.
Yeah.
You look like a space monkey.
Yeah. He's but you know what? It's tough to repeat. in the National Football League.
And any league.
I'm not quick to say that they're going to repeat. I hope we're competitive and we're there. But, you know, with injuries and stuff like that, and we don't have Brandon Graham for the first game, so... Yeah, you know.
You weren't even supposed to win last year, so you're on house money right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I know. So, I know.
You'd be like, we lost. I don't care.
Okay, well, we didn't go to the Super Bowl this year. That's
you're
going to
be sitting
right.
here
I'm
like
still
this.
High.
Oh, did we lose?
Yeah. I'm going to be drinking out of that in like 5 minutes. Trust me. I'll be drinking out of my Super Bowl winning glass. So
same thing with the Caps. They could lose 80 games this year, and I'd be like, okay.
And there's Jamie Nash.
There he is.
The Nasher. What's up, Jamie? Come on, man. We need some comments.
Dwayne said Saints, you know, they got the ageless one down there.
Dwayne, I hate you guys already because you're probably going to be right there at the end. So they got a good team down there. They really do. So you guys, the Rams, I see the 49ers. Oh, my God. Yeah. So anyway, did you watch the PGA Championship?
I did not. I was watching some. Band of Brothers yesterday.
Were you?
Yeah, my son movie. My son had a history camp this week.
That's right.
World War II, so we got him into Band of Brothers.
That's very cool.
So I didn't watch, but I saw it on Twitter. Tiger, 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 Tiger.
Oh, you couldn't. On the Today Show today, they were smoking Tiger Woods crack, man. They were just like, oh, Tiger Woods, did you see it? Boom. He lost by two. You know what? I wasn't impressed. You know? Because they were like, Tiger's chasing you. You know what? Anybody who's two shots behind you is chasing you. Yeah. You know? And you're. Well,
I saw the thing on the kid that won, and I say kid because he's a child.
I don't even know his name.
Yeah.
I can't even say
their names.
Kapaka.
And he's like, yeah, I grew up watching Tiger Woods. Go to hell, kid.
Yeah, just go to hell, you.
I wanted Tiger Woods to come in and just smack him in his face.
You know, but it was good to see the red shirt back out there and the little pumps going.
Yeah.
It was cool. It was cool. You know, that's cool. A lot of people were into it. I was sitting at the deck down at the, it's not Coconut Joe's anymore. It's called something else. But we went down and we were like, yeah, let's go get some drinks on the deck. And we sat, we watched it. Well, the whole bar was crowded and everybody was watching the golf tournament, which was cool. So,
when Tiger is doing the things he does and he's in it in the red shirt on Sunday, people watch. It's fun.
Yeah.
I didn't, but people do.
But maybe you'll watch the next one if he's in it.
Yeah.
Right? Because he's building that momentum. He's coming back. It's 10 years since he won a major.
Yeah.
10 years, ladies and gentlemen. Wow.
Who would have thought that back then?
Yeah. 10 years that Tiger wouldn't win a major. He's coming up on the 10th year. That's crazy. So, but he's back. It looks like he's back. So hopefully he's healthy. He stays healthy. And we got the rest of this year to go. And, you know, he'll be right in it.
As much as people like to take down celebrities and stuff, people love a comeback story.
Yeah.
So, you know, everyone, I'm pulling for him.
Yeah.
I wasn't looking to take him down. So.
All right, I'm going to switch our background.
Yeah, we're out of the football segment.
Boom. Let's go to the Death Star. Shkaboom. There we are. What's the Death Star? I like that Death Star backdrop.
Yeah.
Pretty cool looking. It's pretty sweet. So, guys, subscribe to us on YouTube.
Yeah, because we're there now.
Yeah, now we got it. See the little button down in the corner? Subscribe to us on YouTube. Subscribe, subscribe. Like it, share it. Click the little bell so you get notifications so you know when we go live. Because we're going to be going live a lot over on YouTube and not going live here. I'm just saying. I mean, Monday nights we'll be live on both.
Oh, right.
But I'm going to be going live. You may be doing some live feeds over to YouTube. So we got that all worked out.
Ronnie might do some.
Yes.
Wow, we lost our entire audience. We're down to three.
Wow. Jamie Nash.
What'd you do, Jamie?
Oh, we are so boring. We are absolutely. We did the sports.
That's
what it was.
Robert's gonna kick our ass.
I know it. Everybody's down there in Myrtle Beach, and they're not watching. There's my sister. She's up. My cousin Eric's on. What's up, Eric Muff? My cousin from South Jersey, Eric.
How you doing?
Hey, no, they don't talk like that in South Jersey.
They don't?
No, that's North Jersey.
Oh, they say water.
Yeah, they say water, and you know, going down the shore. You know, going to the shore.
It's more like a Baltimore.
Yeah. It's more Baltimore-ish, but, you know, it's Philadelphia, man. South Jersey accent. So, we got four people now. We're gaining ground. We've got no one on YouTube. That breaks my heart. I'm going to go over there and check it out over on YouTube. Boom. Victor Coco's there.
No, Elizabeth's over there.
Yeah, what the hell?
Well, some people... Okay, so we didn't lose our hole. Some people moved
over to YouTube.
Okay.
There we go.
That feels a little bit better.
But what's happening is that we're not getting, you know, chat box stuff. All right, so you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to come over here to chat box. I'm going to launch the living daylights out of it.
Yeah, so he's doing stuff there.
Yeah.
What's next on the...
We are on. See? Now, we should be getting that over on... See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, we should be getting that over on the other thing. So, let me go back over to here now. Let me minimize that. And let's go to... Here we go. Viewer count. And then I'm going to launch that again. Boom.
Launch.
We got three people.
There you go.
That stuff should be coming up over here. It's not coming up. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Killing us. Come on now. I don't want to go in and start messing with it now, though.
No.
No, because that would be... That would be not good. Mm-mm.
So, what's next on our list over there?
Movies, man.
Movies. So you saw one today.
I did. Check this out. I went and saw this really cool movie.
This looked, I mean...
Called The Meg. Boom.
This
I'm
thing,
telling you.
When I saw the trailer for this before Avengers, I thought, this thing has to be the biggest turd ever.
Look at Jason Statham. Look at, he's epic. Look at him. Look at him.
Just the one delivery. It's The Meg.
It is. Look at him. He's fantastic. I love that guy. Man, I was so psyched. We went, we took the kids and we all went and we just had a blast. We laughed. We were, oh man, people were yelling at the screen. It was such a fun time in the theater.
Okay.
I mean, when you go to the theater and you go into a movie like that, you don't expect it to change your life.
Right, right.
You know, you're just going there to have fun. And we did. We had a blast. It was amazing.
Okay.
So.
Can we get the...
Yeah,
we
can.
There we go.
I'm going to bring it up. Boom.
There we are.
Boom.
So, so you saw that this weekend?
Yeah. We saw The Meg.
Cool.
So, I know it doesn't say we don't have any views from YouTube, but we do. We got three
people. It's going to drive you insane, man.
I know. It's going to drive me nuts
maybe
until
take,
I get
maybe
it to
take
work.
It off and put it back, maybe.
All right. Let's clear it. Right.
Control-Alt-Delete.
Okay. Let's bring it back up. Nope.
Nope.
Although we are getting the Facebook comments, which is fantastic.
That'll work.
Yeah, so we'll just keep doing that. And it should be updating our YouTube watchers as well, which
right.
It's not. So.
So other movie news.
Other movie news. The Meg was fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. If you get a chance, see it. I saw it in IMAX, which was awesome. Do you ever see movies in IMAX?
Occasionally.
Awesome.
When they don't make me do 3D IMAX, because
yeah.
I hate 3D.
I don't like 3D stuff.
3D either. Just pisses me off. Yeah. Meg Ryan. Is Meg Ryan in The Meg?
No.
Oh, The Meg.
Meg. I get it. The Meg. Meg Ryan.
She had to get a little work done.
She did. She looked like The Meg, to be honest.
Oh, shit. I meant The Shark.
So, all right. So, talking about movies and movie stuff, right? What about these guys? What do you think about these guys right now?
What do I think about them?
What do you think about these guys?
I'd like one.
All right, me
or
too.
Or four.
But what do you think about this popular Oscar thing that's out there now?
Popular Oscar?
Yeah, popular Oscar. What do you think about that?
Pop and lock?
Yeah, what do you think about that?
You know, I don't have a problem with it.
No.
I know a lot of people do, but
do you think it's going to change ratings? Do you think people are going to watch because of that?
No.
By adding that?
Not really.
I don't think so either.
I
think it's going to create confusion as to what actually is the best film out there. And by just having a popular Oscar, what it says is the one that won Best Picture was the most unpopular of the, you know what I mean?
You know, and here's, like, they have the same issue over on Broadway. You know, a lot of the theater purists say they hate that these Disney movies like Frozen and Lion King and Beauty and the Beast are all being adapted for stage,
sure.
And that's what people are coming to see. But so what? You have those plays there. It's bringing people to Broadway. It's bringing people to New York. They're seeing these things. They're falling in love with theater, and then they're going to see Hamilton and Wicked and My Fair Lady and whatever else.
Well,
and,
I get that. I get that Broadway, but it's
right.
It's a different animal though, movies, because
but if
they're not having a tough time getting people in the seats though, really, with the blockbusters.
But if Avengers is up for an Oscar,
mm-hmm.
you know,
for what?
Popular Oscar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, obviously it's up for all the technical crap, and they'll do it early in the show when they do all the technical stuff. I don't mean crap. I much respect for the technical people. I don't want to make it that clear.
Yes.
But the
that's who makes me look so good.
Yes. But they'll do it, you know, middle of the show ish. Keep people around to see what that is, and hopefully then maybe those people will see the clip, see the some of these awards get handed out, and they'll say, oh, well, maybe I'll go watch that movie. So I think it's the idea is that it's going to be kind of a gateway drug, you know, to the more artistic films, the more art. Yeah.
I'm not a fan. I'd rather they didn't do it. I'd rather they did what they were going to do and, like, do some of the technical ones during the breaks. Like the short documentary. Eh, you can do that during the break. I don't care.
Right.
You know, short film, foreign film, do it during the break. I don't care. But, you know, the big ones, best picture, best actor, actress, obviously, screenwriter. Yeah. You know, those things, well, they should be during the show.
That's what, when you get to, like, the SAG Awards.
Yeah.
We don't have all that other stuff. So it's just actor, supporting actor, actress, supporting actress, ensemble, TV, film, and that's it. And then they're off. We do, I saw Christina post, they need a category for stunts.
Stunts, and that's true.
SAG does. Yeah. SAG has a stunt ensemble.
And but I think the Oscars should,
and the
too.
Oscars don't do ensemble, so the way SAG does. So I don't really, what the Oscars needs is a damn casting director
That would
award.
Be good, too.
Outstanding achievement in casting. The Emmys have it.
Yep. So, yeah, I'm not a big fan of the popular Oscar. If they put it in, it's fine. I'm still going to watch because it's my industry and that's what I do. But it just seems to me that we have MTV. We have the People's Choice. We have that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's that. And how are you going to determine who's the popular Oscar? Is it box office receipts? Is it? Because I'll tell you right now, box office receipts don't tell the actual story of people who actually walked through the door and sat and watched the film.
And the thing they could have done, you know, they expanded the number of best pictures. Best Picture nominees. So nominate, instead of adding a category, nominate
a
Skyfall,
film.
Nominate Wonder Woman, nominate Black Panther this year.
Well, they popular films in the past have been in the
Titanic
run.
Was
yeah,
one
and Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
And, you know, so popular films have been nominated in the past. It just doesn't happen that frequently.
Right.
And for some weird reason, I don't know what it is. Any of the Harry Potters could have been nominated, you know, because they were all fantastic. So, I don't know. Does it lower the prestige? Some people feel it does. Some people feel it doesn't. Some people feel that it's updating something that it's needed to be updated after, you know. So
they
change
gave, they
always.
Gave Shirley
is
Temple
real.
A mini Oscar. I mean, back when it first started. So, you know, they've done weird things through the years to award the things that they want to award. They want to have a way to acknowledge these billion-dollar films. You know, like. Like the Meg. Outstanding
the
achievement
Meg.
In
sharks.
In shark
in
face.
Big sharks. And let me tell you something. You know who's in it? Dwight Schrute.
Yes, I saw.
And it's amazing. It's amazing. You got to see what happens to Dwight. It's fun. I don't want to spoil, but fun stuff happens to Dwight. I'm just saying. So.
It's just too bad Snakes on a Plane couldn't get nominated.
Hey. Don't you ever badmouth Snakes on a Plane, man.
I'm sick and tired of these snakes on this plane.
What kind of snakes? Don't say it. Don't say it. We won't be able to promote it. Oh, man. So how about this stuff today that
damn,
came out?
Damn, Christina. What the hell?
What's that?
The show runs too long.
What is she yapping about?
She's saying we're running too long.
The show runs too long.
Damn.
Appletini's runs too long?
I think she means the Oscars.
Oh, the Oscar. I thought she meant us, man. I thought we were going to have to brawl. That's all right, Christina. I thought you were talking about us there for a second. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. So anyway, don't forget, subscribe to us on YouTube, right? We're going to get this figured out so we can see how many people are actually watching us. I can't believe that that's not working tonight. Look at that. It's working over here, right? If I hit the launch button, boom. It's telling us.
Yep.
It's telling us right there.
That's right, Dwayne. No Oscar.
No Oscar for us. No Oscar for us. Look, Christina's like, bring it.
Bring it. Oh, it's been brought on.
Oh, bring it. Don't make me. Jill Redding's on. Hey, Jill Redding. Thanks for joining us. So, did you see the stuff today Omar Sharif Jr. got all PO'd about?
I didn't know he was involved. I don't even know who he is. But, I mean, I know who Omar Sharif is.
Omar Sharif's kid.
But I did catch a little bit of that.
So, essentially what it is Disney is coming out with a movie with an openly gay character, and apparently it's the first openly gay character in a Disney movie.
Except for Josh Gad in Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. So.
Who was, by the way, also straight?
Yeah. So the problem is that Omar Sharif started this whole storm of, you know, that should be played by a gay person. Then, I'm scratching my head at that one. I don't quite understand why. I mean, okay. So that means Dan can only play a middle-aged white guy who works at an insurance company, and I can only play some, you know, slacker, unemployed, living in his basement, hiding from his wife and kids. So is that pretty much it? That's yes. the only guy yes. I get to play?
Yes.
Because I don't get it. I don't get it. It boggles my mind. I don't understand.
Well, you know, I think there's been a lot of gay actors who have played straight.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them in massive, massive blockbusters. But
yeah.
And
you know, I don't want to start naming them, but no. you know, well, we know who they are.
The guy that plays Will. Eric McDonough.
Yeah, no. Will and Grace.
McCormick. He's straight. No one's had a problem with that for, you know, a decade.
You know, I don't know. Viggo Mortensen, you know? He plays straight dude.
Yeah,
in
all the time.
Films.
So should he not play Aragorn?
Yeah, I guess not.
I guess, according to this dude.
Well,
so, but and that's the problem. Like they had the thing with Scarlett Johansson where she was going to play a post-op trans person.
Rub and tug, yeah, right. yeah.
But she's Scarlett Johansson. When she's in a movie, the movie makes a lot of money. When you hire somebody who might actually be a post-op trans person, well, they're not a star. No one's going to... The producers aren't going to put the money into the project. I don't know.
I understand exactly what you're saying. It's a business, ladies and gentlemen. Show business. They want somebody that's going to put asses in the seats. And if you're a nobody who nobody knows, they're not going to hire you to play in a funded film at that level. They're not, you know,
you'll have a chance to be in the movie, but that star that the whole thing rests on is going to be a named person.
Are we done with that?
No.
All right, well, I'll take a little more. I know you are, but I do have some Pilsner in there if you want to go with that. So thank you very much.
Sure.
More apple tea for me. So yeah, it kind of it's getting to be an old story quick with that.
But the thing is it like, don't be exclusionary. Like, make sure that there are chances for every voice to be heard, every type of actor to...
Absolutely. Yeah. They're telling these stories of these people. Right?
Yeah.
That didn't sound good, did
it? I know.
Right?
No.
Of these people?
Yeah.
Like, they're different?
No.
They're not. I know. That was bad. I'm sorry. I apologize. I didn't want to go in that...
Right.
Yeah. But they're telling the stories, and you know what? Actors are actors. They act and they play different types of characters.
We do.
Yeah. I've played a gay character in a film and a play. And
we played a gay couple.
Yeah.
And in that same movie, there was a gay guy playing a straight person.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's very, it's sad that we're having this conversation. You know? I mean, I feel bad for Jack Whitehall. He's an actor doing his job. And he's getting vilified because,
right.
you know. Because he's doing his job. There's D-Wayne. D-Wayne says, yes.
Fans are telling Ruby Rhodes she can't play a gay character because she's not gay enough.
We're going to get to that coming up, Christina Herrick. And yes, we're going to talk about that. We are going to talk about that. So, in the Who Gives a Crap department, we just jump right into it.
Thank you, Christina.
Okay. So, in my Who Gives a Crap department is, boom, Ruby Rhodes' Batwoman. I don't care. That she's a lesbian. I don't care. Yeah, I guess she's not gay enough. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what level of gayness does she need to be at to play this character. And if she wasn't gay, why couldn't she play the character? I don't understand. But here's my thing. The one reason I think she shouldn't play this character.
Right.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Because she sucks.
Oh.
She is not a good actor
at
all. She ruined John Wick 2 for me. Ruined it. Ruined it. And I love John Wick. I love Keanu Reeves.
She'll see you later.
Who will?
Ruby Rose.
Will she?
She did all the...
Oh, yeah. That's what she was doing. Well, let me tell you something, Ruby Rose. You're like the Vin Diesel.
You know, but here's the thing.
Boom.
Like, you can hate an actor, a performance, or what the director, writer, producer put that character into. But these fanboys and these people who are just butthurt over the way these movies play out, they're running these people off of Twitter. Like they're just they're making it impossible for a person to enjoy. Like you post like, hey, had some shrimp today. And they're like, you know what sucks? Your shrimp and you in that movie. You know, like and it's just battery like ongoing.
But here's the deal, Dan. If it was you or me, right? You ain't running me off Twitter. You can say whatever you want. I would collect all the best ones where people busted my balls, and then I would do a live video and read those out loud. Because it's totally ridiculous. So Ruby Rose, how soft are you? You're gonna run from Twitter? Come on, man, toughen up.
But you're like Bane. You know, you're sitting over there. You were born in this smack. You didn't until you left Philly. Like the rest of us, we aren't like you. We didn't grow up giving it and taking it the way they do in that Philly area.
I know. You gotta know my cousins. You need to know my uncles. Yeah, we didn't stand a chance.
Yeah.
You know, growing up as kids there, we totally just got our balls busted. As soon as we came out of the womb, somebody was busting your balls.
Hey, you purple? Yeah. What the hell?
And then you just, every day of your life.
You can't breathe.
That was what it was like. So, you know, I'm kind of used to it and stuff just rolled right off my back. I don't care. You can tell me I suck all day long. I don't give a shit. I'm just not you at the end of the day. So there you have it. But the thing is, she ran from Twitter, and I feel bad that she did, but come on, you gotta be tougher than that. You're a star. You're making, cash your checks, Ruby Rose. Cash your checks. Doesn't matter what I say about you. I don't think you're a good actor, but you know what? You're in John Wick 2.
You're Batwoman.
Yeah, you're
so
Batwoman.
So go be Batwoman.
Yeah, and ignore the haters. Go do your thing. You're not gay enough. You got what? Whatever.
Because you can't be worse than Alicia Silverstone.
Yeah, go do your thing, kid. All right? So
and
what
I
if people don't
Alicia
like
Silverstone?
It?
Not, I mean...
Love.
I enjoy Alicia Silverstone.
So anyway, Christina Herrick, you know what? Ruby Rose is Batwoman, and that's pretty much it.
There you go.
I don't think that's going to change.
No.
You know? And, you know, people watch it, great. If they don't, it'll be canceled. Like every other television show in the world, it finally gets canceled. Name one. Oh, The Simpsons. But that's been on forever. So
forever.
South Park, been on forever. But those are cartoons. Those aren't real.
South Park's still on?
Yeah.
Grey's Anatomy's still on.
Mm. It'll eventually go
away. Every now and then, something will pop up, and I'm like, that show was
Law and Order went away, finally. You know what I mean?
Max SVU, though, did it?
Yeah, that's still on.
Yeah.
But, you know, the original is gone. Because eventually, all television shows get canceled. And ones like Batwoman and, you know, shows like that, they last for 3 to 5 seasons, and then they're gone. It's the way they go.
DeLuca!
Dan DeLuca's on board. Finally. Thanks, Dan. Show's almost over. What's up? Come on, man. That's what I'm talking about. Chaps my ass.
And that's my who gives a crap.
I went right to DeLuca and I said, did you see my movie yet? And he goes, no. And I'm like, well, wait a minute. You're in it. How did you not see The Night Watchman? That sucks. Come on.
I'm pretty sure he did that. I think he leaves the theater every time it plays.
Every time, yeah. That's what she said. Well, that is what she said. Anyway, what else you got? You got anything for Who Gives a Crap?
The Omarosa thing I don't really give a lot of a crap about.
Oh, my God.
I didn't back when she was on The Apprentice.
Oh, my God.
I didn't give a crap about The Apprentice. I don't give a crap about most of it.
So
I mean, I give a lot of crap, but not about...
Did you see her today on the Today Show?
No.
I watched it live. It was ridiculous. She is an idiot of the highest order. I couldn't believe what she was saying to Savannah. And Savannah was like, are you serious right now, Omarosa? You could just see it in her face. Like, are you doing this right now? Are you doing this? And the day before, she was on Meet the Press, and Maria was there, because Maria worked on it.
Was she here in D.C.?
Yeah.
Oh.
And she was on Meet the Press, and Maria was like, she said totally the opposite yesterday on Meet the Press. And now she's totally telling a different tune today on Today's Show. What is going on with this woman? She's out of her mind. Out of her mind.
Nobody gives a crap.
Nobody gives a crap. Omarosa, go away.
Please.
I thought you were gone in 2004 after The Apprentice. And then boom, boom,
whoa,
boom.
Whoa,
look
whoa.
At that.
What the hell just happened?
I know it.
That was wild. I thought maybe all of our YouTube comments popped in at once.
I know. It was just like... Brrrrat. Oh, maybe like we were on a we were bound up, man, and all of a sudden we just
cheese will do that.
We got the enema, the comment enema, and
the comment enema,
and they all just shat out at once, man. That was crazy. I can't even keep up to that now. That was insane.
So we have a Broadway section, don't we?
We do. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Neil Marshall Jackson, Mississippi Jr. sent in a Broadway segment, and we're going to play that right now. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Robert, for your Broadway segment.
Hey, this is Robert Neil Marshall with the special theater section for Appletinis with Ken. And before I start, I just want to say a big shout out to a particular person out there. Ken, I don't know if you realize it, but we have a stalker fan out there. In particular, has been posting pictures online about some of the work that you and I have done. And that stalker fan is Elizabeth. It's your sister. So Elizabeth, shout out to you. Appreciate it. You're kind of scaring me with all this stuff that's coming up from the past, but very honored and very tickled, as I know your brother is as well. Those were episodes of A Haunting that I did, oh my God, at least a decade ago. I just wanted to share that tonight is sort of a special night in New York on Broadway because of the opening of a new show produced by Ken Davenport called Getting the Band Together. They're having their opening night as we speak tonight. I'm sorry I can't be there live, but I'm glad that I could at least do a remote for you. I just want to mention that Ken Davenport's a very special man to many of us. In 2005, I did a show produced and directed by Ken Davenport called Awesome 80s Prom. At the Hippodrome, it's sort of a throwback, interactive comedy, and I played mean Principal Snellgrove in this show. I subsequently got the opportunity to work off-Broadway in this show as an understudy as well, and that's when I got to meet and work with the most delightful, incredibly wonderful Kathy Searle, who's come and taught many of our Actors Club students, and she just worked in Bill Tillman and the Outlaws with me and also with Ken Arnold, and who's absolutely an amazing talent, and we love Kathy. And so there's this core of people. Ken Davenport also was involved with a show called Altar Boys, was one of his first shows. Ken also worked on a show that just won a Tony Award for Best Revival.
This is not how I expected this night to go at this beginning of this evening. This is a business where you hear no an awful lot. So this award is dedicated to all the people who said yes to this production. Stephen Flaherty and Lynn Ahrens, who said yes when this producer, who 20 years ago got their house seats for them. To Paul Libin, who said yes when we brought 1,000 pounds of sand, 100 gallons of water, and a goat and 2 chickens into his theater. To our designers, to Camille Brown, our choreographer, to every single one of the co-producers and investors who put money into this show, people who support the theater are the reason we all have a job. Thank you so much.
Ken has been working on this with several people from Awesome 80s Prom for about 10 years now, almost 10 years. And so tonight's the opening night. The crowds are coming, and it's really going to be exciting to see what happens.
Get the band back together.
Get the boys back together.
Get the band back together.
Rock in the face of a place that remembers when a band from this small town
brought the motherfucking room down.
We're taking it back.
So a little bit of what's going on in the theater world with a personal connection to all of us here. So break legs, Ken Davenport, and much love from all of us, and we'll be seeing you around. Back to you, Ken.
Thank you, Robert Neil Marshall, for that lovely it's on.
Cool.
It's on. All right. Thanks, Robert, for sending that in. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, hey,
we love getting some theater, some class on here.
Exactly. Class. That looks like a great show starting tonight, which is fantastic. Hopefully, you know, maybe we should take a road trip.
That'd be great.
And we should all go see it. So, anyway, one of our friends is going to be on Broadway soon. Or, like, slightly off Broadway.
Who's that?
Matt Servito.
Oh, is he?
Yes, September. He's going to be in a show.
Awesome.
Just slightly off Broadway. And when we find out what that show is, we should all go to it.
Absolutely.
Definitely. I'm going
to
be there.
I'm going to have to go to Broadway soon.
So, look.
Apparently,
DeLuke is making comments. Robert Neil Marshall will haunt you.
He's always making comments. Those Italians won't shut up.
You know what? Yeah, you know what? Robert Neil Marshall will haunt you. Look, yeah, he was in The Haunting, and now he's haunting us in real life.
I feel like our friend Kathy, Michael, the puppet master, his mom posted on my wife's wall today that Joey McIntyre from The New Kids, that's my wife's new kid, he's in a play on Broadway, and so I'm sure I'll have to
go to that.
Go see that one. I liked the last two that I saw him in, because we saw Tick, Tick, Boom.
That was great.
Which was great.
Yeah, it's
great.
Love that. Great show.
So we saw that off-Broadway. He was in that. Mm-hmm. And then we didn't plan this, but he happened to be in Wicked when we went and saw it. So,
every time you tap on there?
Yeah, like, I'm sorry.
Boom, boom, boom. Sorry. Just saying. I can't hear it in the headphones, but I know it's happening.
Gotcha.
So, can I get one of them beers out of there, man? Let's crack one of those suckers open. And I'm going to put it in my World Championship Eagles glass. Thanks, Dan.
I'm not going to put it in my World Championship Eagles glass.
I do have a Redskins glass around here somewhere.
You do?
If you want to throw it in there.
I don't. I'm good.
You're good?
I have to go home tonight.
You don't want to drink the pills?
No.
I bought it just for you.
Next time.
I mean, pills is okay, but you know, it's not my favorite.
Really?
I was like, yeah, I'll get it for Dan.
All right.
And then Dan doesn't even drink it. My feelings are hurt.
So,
I need a minute.
So yeah, and Captain Tough on Twitter over here is gonna have a cry.
That's right, man. I'm not leaving Twitter for nobody.
Hey, Rosie Greer told us in kindergarten that it's all right to cry. Remember that? Free to be you and me, man.
Yes, Rosie Greer, who is good friends with Darby Hinton, who I was just in the Bill Tillman movie with.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Rosie Greer. Big Rosie Greer. So, fantastic.
It's all right to cry. Now, so is Bob going to get us hit on YouTube over there? Because Tracy Lauper, Cindy Lauper was in that segment?
Probably.
Damn.
That's all right. You know, I'm just trying to get a YouTube subscribe button up. There we go. Boom. We're back up. We're over there, too. We're on both.
Oh, yeah.
The only thing that's not happening is our numbers on YouTube. We do have people watching on YouTube, by the way. Three.
It's the magic number.
It's better than none, right? And we do have people watching over here. We got 5. So I can see the numbers right here, how many we actually have. And I'm going to come in here right now.
DeLuca asked where Johnny G is. Don't you know better than to ask questions?
We actually have 12 folks
watching. What's the matter with you?
Johnny G here? Is Johnny G here?
No, DeLuca asked where's Johnny G.
Johnny G, he's got the night off. So we miss Johnny G. We want Johnny G here, but we can't do our segment. What would
Johnny G's taking care of family business.
Hey, you know how
forget
it is?
About it. There's Kevin.
Jiggets.
You missed our football segment, Kevin.
We didn't even mention the Raiders.
We didn't. Once. But we will now.
Yeah.
Chucky's back.
Yeah, he is.
That deranged psycho.
It's sad at best.
You know, I don't think it is.
No, you think he's going to do
well? Because it's part of his job.
Mm-hmm.
He's been going through and...
Look at Robert was ghosting us, man.
Oh, he has been.
Yeah, look at it. Look,
that wasn't Cindy Lauper singing?
No.
Okay, I didn't realize. It sounded like the real song. Chucky's been going into all these on Monday night. He spends the week watching them practice. He knows all the coaches, all their tendencies, what they're talking about in the film room.
Do you think?
Yeah, I think he's got some insider information.
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
At least until the
maybe
next...
Maybe that's what he's been doing for the past 3 years.
He's big old notebook.
He's like, I'm going to get all the tendencies of all the coaches in the NFL, and then I'm going to come back and kick all their asses.
He's a freak. He gets up at like... He only gets like 4 hours of sleep a night.
Schwarzenegger, too. That's what he said.
Really?
He only gets like 4 hours of sleep a night. That's all you need, he said. That's all you need. 4 hours.
I watched Predator last night. Was on.
The original?
The original. Yeah. I got time.
Yes. See, yeah, yes. The prom soundtrack. Oops, that's right. Cyndi Lauper. Busted, Robert. Gotcha. We knew we were going to get you. Nah. Anyway, but we don't care. So we'll get nabbed. On YouTube.
It just means that Cyndi Lauper will make a couple bucks off of our 3 views.
Thought you meant the band musical. No. We didn't mean that, Robert. We did not mean that.
She looks great, by the way, Mary Lou Henner.
Meredith Henner or Cyndi Lauper?
Meredith Henner, not Cyndi Lauper. Cyndi Lauper would never look great.
She looks good in the commercial, you see, with the skin, the psoriasis. Okay. She does. She looks great.
Meredith Henner looks as good as she did on Taxi.
Ah, Meredith Henner is beautiful. I love Meredith Henner. But, excuse me, so does Cyndi Lauper. She doesn't look bad. Okay. I thought she looks good in it. They use that soft filter that makes her fuzzy, so you really can't see all the wrinkles.
So, yeah. It's a lot of quick cuts like they use with Fergie.
Exactly. So, you know, we've been on for almost an hour.
We have.
We got to wrap this up.
We got to shut up.
We got to shut the hell up, let you people go back about your lives. I see hearts popping up. Kevin Jiggets ruined your life. Yes, Dan DeLuca, I know Kevin Jiggets ruined your life. He's ruined my life as well. You know, but I still love the guy.
My life's better because he's in it.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn you, Dan. Damn you, Dan Franco. So anyway, Dan, you want to play a quick game of Where to Bleep Am I?
Sure.
All right, go ahead, go over, and I'll bring it up. We're going to play Where the Bleep Am I and see if...
It's going to be quick. We're late.
It's going to be quick. Yeah, we're a little late, but, you know, what the hell. All right.
Oh, wait, I can see the...
You can see? All right, see there's a board over there on the ground?
I just turned it off.
You turned it off?
Yep.
Sweet. All right, you ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Boom, 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 bam, bam, bam. Where is Dan Franco?
Where in the world is Dan Franco?
Boom. All right, man.
All right. Is it a tourist attraction?
No.
No. Is it on this planet?
Yes.
Yes. Is it a natural landmark?
No.
Is it I keep doing that. Well, I guess the mic's not on this table. Is it sporting related?
Is it sporting related?
Yeah.
No.
No. Would I go there in the summer?
You would.
I would.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the pool?
It's kind of a pool.
Is it a natural body of water?
Yes.
Is it the place you killed yourself off of that rope swing?
No.
No. Is it a lake?
No.
Ocean?
Yes.
Specific ocean?
Yeah, but...
Specific Pacific Ocean?
No.
That's what chaps my ass when people say Pacifically.
Yes, I mean, it's should be...
You mean the ocean?
Yeah. But actually, it's not. It's an ocean in a fictional place. So, and I need to clarify that a little bit.
An ocean in a fictional place.
Yeah.
Is
That's
it,
right.
It Game of Thrones?
No.
No, but no. Something like that.
Yeah. You've only seen the trailer. You haven't seen the rest of it yet.
Oh, so this is the Meg? Is the shark behind me?
Yes, it is.
Is he about to eat me?
Yes, he is.
Can I do my Jason Statham?
Yes, do your Jason Statham.
It's the Meg.
Perfect, you got it. Yes, you were in front of the Megalodon. Boom, good job, Dave.
Thank you.
Did you blow the candle out?
I did.
So anyway, that was the thing. Look, see?
Oh, that's
pretty cool. Jason Statham was right there. You were blocking him.
I was.
Yeah. So, and now you're back over here. Boom. There's Dan Franco. Boom. Was any good? Who just said was it any good?
DeLuca. He wasn't here earlier.
Oh, you weren't here earlier. Yeah, it was good. It was cheesily, fantastically
good in that good. Bad movie that you have a lot of fun.
Yes, just having fun. Like
thing.
The movie we never talk about.
That's a good movie. That is a solid B-.
I know it. Well, according to some people. According to other people, it sucks. But well,
yeah. But like those people haven't chased us off of Twitter yet. So
yeah, that one guy that came on and was like, I've seen better student films. Well, I want to see the goddamn student films you're watching, pal.
Yeah.
Because if student films are better than that...
We're going to hire that guy for Night
exactly,
Watchmen 2.
For the next one.
So, how is that Pilsner?
Fantastic. You said you didn't want one.
Okay.
But it's good. You can sip that one if you really want it. I don't have any diseases right now. So, it's actually pretty good. It's unfiltered pills. So...
That's good.
I told you.
Sierra Nevada.
That's right. Sierra Nevada always does a good beer.
No, okay. Dan, it wasn't better than TNW. Nothing's better than TNW.
Are you crazy?
You see, now this is what pisses me off about the popular Oscar. Came a year too late.
That's right.
Yep.
Because The Night Watchman would have been in there. We would have been nominated for a popular Oscar.
We didn't plan this, by the way. We both did. That's like
that was
choreographed.
Cool. Did you see that? That was fantastic.
Peripheral vision.
I was like, yep. That was sweet. I was like, no way we just did that. And then, yes, Dan DeLuca, Sheriff Skittles, is on his way. I can't say much about Sheriff Skittles, ladies and gentlemen, but Sheriff Skittles will be in our next movie.
Okay.
Just saying that. I'm just saying that. And guess who plays Skittles, Sheriff Skittles?
Oh, Jimmy?
No.
No. You?
Yours truly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep. Mustache coming back?
No.
No. Okay. Good.
Just saying. I'm just saying. Oh, by the way,
Elizabeth just won first place at trivia with her rack. I'm sorry. It scrolled up and I didn't.
With her rack? Whoa. Whoa.
It moved.
Just won first place trivia at racks. Okay. That's a place in Jersey that she goes and hangs out at the bar.
Is it a pool hall?
It is. They have pool tables there. Racks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's a strip club.
Yeah. The Night Watchman 2, Dan DeLuca. I don't know. When are we doing that? Let's get to work. I mean, shit, I got a camera and a microphone. Check out this microphone. We can make a movie.
Yeah, we can.
I'm telling you. Let's do puppets. We'll get Michael on board. We'll just make a puppet movie. Isn't that going to be a puppet movie coming out
soon? Yeah, and I think the Muppets are actually, like, Henson is involved in that thing.
Is he?
Yep. Well, not the Henson, because he's dead.
Yeah, but their crew out in L.A. Yeah. You ever drive past that place in L.A.?
No. I've never been to L.A.
What? We're going.
Working on it.
We're going. We're going. We're going to go.
Okay.
Over the next year, that's a goal. We're going to go to L.A. together.
There we go. All
right?
In-N-Out Burger.
You, me, we'll get DeLuca to go. We'll all go to L.A. And we'll meet some people. You never know. You might meet somebody.
Yeah.
You know, somebody that can help you out. Like an agent, manager, somebody. I don't know. Just saying.
It can't win the Oscar now, Dan, because it was released outside of the eligibility window for the 2019 Oscars.
Just missed it.
Did I just, like, skip? My record skipped.
Oh, you almost got it. Almost got it.
Yeah.
Almost got it. Anyway, we're down to 7 people. We got to get out of here.
We got to go.
Because it's getting late. But I'm actually glad because we were able to, look at that. We were able to go here. And we were able to go on Facebook. The thing is that we didn't get the comments to go from YouTube over to our feed for some weird reason. And it was working earlier tonight, and it just shut down for some odd, bizarre, crazy reason. I don't know. YouTube really doesn't like us right now. I don't know what that is. But
it's DeLuca's fault.
It is DeLuca's fault. We're going to blame DeLuca. So, anyway, guys.
Did you want that?
Yes. One thing before we go. A friend of ours, a good family friend, and she has been a pillar of the community here in Annapolis for many years. She had a stroke in mid-July, and she's had a tough time of it. You know, she was in a hospital for a while. She's at home now, but she's going through rehab and everything. But they're having problems, you know, paying for medical bills, and her business is, you know, she ran a business, Pit Boys, who sponsors us on occasion as well. If you can, I'm going to post a GoFundMe on Appletinis with Ken's page. If you can, and you can help out, you know, they're trying to raise some money to pay for her medical costs and help out. So if you get an opportunity, please click on the link, the GoFundMe link for Marla George. I'll put it on our Facebook page. And please go there and help out if you can. She's a fantastic woman. She's a pillar of the community here. They've had a restaurant here in this community for a very long time. I've spent many a day at the pool across the street hanging out with her and her husband. They're great people, but they're in a tough situation right now. So if you get an opportunity to help them out, even if it's just like $5, you know, help them out. And thank you for that. Because these people are the really good, solid citizens of the United States of America. And, you know, when people need help, we got to help.
Yep.
That's it. Final, done, let's help. Let's figure out a way, let's help these guys out. So, thank you guys for watching. Dan Franco.
We'll see you next time.
Next week. You know who's going to be the guest on the show, Dave?
Tom Selleck.
This son of a bitch. Finally. right here, this guy, Tom Selleck, coming on my show. He's doing those stupid-ass reverse mortgage commercials. He can come on Appletini's.
Yeah, their entire, like, industry is backed on him. They probably throw a bank at him.
His ass better come on this show, because if he can do a reverse mortgage commercial, he can do Appletini's with Ken.
He can do a reverse Appletini.
That's right. He'll stand facing that way and drink. Is that what a reverse Appletini is?
Now we can get anybody and say he's doing a
reverse Appletini.
Oh, hi, yeah. I had a great time on Magnum.
There it is.
The new one sucks.
I saw the preview for it before the Meg. It was terrible. I wanted to punch the IMAX screen as hard as I could.
But the new Higgins, I like.
I like her.
Yeah.
She's fantastic. That's what I said while we were in the theater. I was like, you know what? I don't have a problem with any of the other characters.
Except for Magnum.
That's the one I didn't want.
But that's the thing. Terrible. You can't cast that role. There's no one that can fill those shoes.
Oh, God. Especially a 5'5" Latino dude that looks like a woman.
Like, how are you going to come back and recast Indiana Jones? You can't. He's Indiana Jones.
Ah.
Just like you can't cast Han Solo.
Can't do it.
Or... Actually, I liked the kid that played Han Solo.
Did you? I haven't seen it yet. Anyway. All right, Dan. Thanks for joining me. Appreciate it, pal.
Thank you.
Johnny G, we miss you. Robert, we miss you. When are you guys coming back in studio so we can hang out? I'll see you guys next time. Next Monday night, we'll be right here hiding in the basement again from the wife and kids. We'll see you guys. Have a fantastic week. Enjoy your Appletinis this week and be good to each other. Peace.
You know, this is a really bad hiding spot, right?
Appletinis with Ken.
It's terrible.
Appletinis with Ken. Oh, yeah. Appletinis with Ken. Appletinis with Ken. Appletinis with Ken. Appletinis with Ken. Oh, yeah.